Yo, everybody, it's Nostalgia Scott coming at you guys with another epic video of Donkey Kong Country 3. So let's go get whatever Funky's got for us for giving him that patch. A patch? Oh yeah, this is just what I needed. Hang on for just a couple of seconds, Kongs, and I'll whip up a cool new tub for you to rub-a-dub-dub. Ooh, weird. Got my Pepsi for recording with me. I'm a hire vehicle. We'll do the whole mission thing I said at the end of the game. Let's grab our... I believe this is a hovercraft. Now, we can actually go over here and do something. I usually do this later, but we can do this. There is another banana bird secret right here. The Kong Cave. Yellow, green, red, blue, red. Yellow, green, red, blue, red. There we go. Now the banana bird get. 6. I like how it has like the DK coin sound effect. It's just weird. I don't know, Donkey Kong Country 3 always has a special place in my heart. I find it the best of all of them. My personal opinion. Number 2 follows very close, and then number 3... number 1 will be last. I don't know, number 1 was just like the beginner game, you know? Anyways, let's go to Cotton Top Cove and... What's Blue's Beach Hut?
Hello there, Kongs. How are you? My name's Blue, but pleased to meet you. I got lots of mail, you know, but it's all bills.
That's actually not what he says in the original game. Now, I believe there's another secret right here. Bounty Bay. So, yellow, green, yellow, blue, yellow. Fuck, it was green. Why did I do that? I knew which one it was, too. Blue, yellow, 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 yellow. So, blue, and then just a bunch of yellows. There we go. My girlfriend just sent me a word game thingy here. So let me just do this for her. Hang on, this is gonna take literally 2 seconds. We're gonna put the word steep. You know, like a steep cliff. Anyways, let's go to the first level of this world known as Bazza's Blockade. Now we have this epic underwater theme. I don't know, like, this is an epic underwater theme, and I'm glad they kept this one from the original game. I will be playing the originals at some point for, like, the consoles. Probably, like, next year, or maybe the year after. I don't want to play them too close together. How the fuck did I manage that, man? Can I get these manners? I want to have, like, a bajillion lives when I'm done. Oh, great, there's lots of Coco the Gay Clownfish. Guys from my stream, like, love that name. Like, when I streamed on... Thine Time Walker, aka Canadian Gamer. I don't know, like, I swear now that I'm not Canadian Gamer, people don't know who I am, so they're like, oh wait, who the fuck is this? We'll unsub to him. Turns out it's me all along. Anyways, first bonus is find the coin. I believe you can literally just sit down here until the ending. See? Really easy, you can cheat it. Alright. Still down here though, which is evil. And oh, life! 46 lives in World 3. I believe this is actually supposed to be World 3. Mechanos, I believe, is level 4, but you can go to either one at this point. Just like when you get to like the next portion, like after you unlock your next boat, there's 3 worlds. 2 if you play the original, 3 if you play this game. So they do give you some variety. Which is nice, because it's the first Donkey Kong Country game, and only Donkey Kong Country game, I believe, that actually has, like, an actual optional way you can go to, like, different worlds to do first. Like, you have to do them all, obviously, but you don't have to do a specific one first. The music here is kind of weird sounding, like, it feels like it's almost cutting off. Might just be my headset. My headset is getting close to dying, so... Sad as that is, it's the truth. The truth of it all. Not everything lasts forever, guys. And we got 21 bear coins, which I believe we need 99 altogether for all the collectibles. Which I believe are literally all for banana birds. And fuck! Alright, pardon the F-bomb there, guys, but that was just evil. Hey, how come there's no sound effect for that? Anyways, bash the baddies. Well, this is how we get a guard in this level.
Hey, Coco! Coco! Coco!
In the original game, these guys go in so far that you end up having to wait, and it just gets annoying. Like, this is actually a lot more difficult on the original. This game does have some added difficulties features, you know? Boom. Now, if you die with him, the chances of going back and getting him are pretty slim, because who's gonna go back to a bonus and redo it just to get Engard? This is the second time we've seen Engard, right? And I remember when jumping in the barrel would give you an extra buddy. Oh, and Coin will be at the ending of the level, by the way. Coin is always found at the ending of the level in water levels. Oh, hey, Bounty Bass. I believe there's an entire level dedicated to the Bounty and Booty enemies. Bounty Bass and Booty Bird, you know? Bananas, right? Oh, the letter G. Thank you for my 47th life. Now, where is Coin? Coin's over here. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Boom. Anything down here? Nope, nothing. Let's beat the level. Level 1 beaten. So far, we got 100% on everything. Let's go to the next level, which is a waterfall level known as Rocket Barrel Ride. I believe this world is all in order too. Like, I believe it's only world 2 in this game that's all screwed up for some reason, and I don't know why, but it is. Now, Dixie is gonna be your best friend in these levels, except for when it comes to those big guys that only Kitty can kill, and I believe this is just a letter or coin or something. Or bananas. Even worse than what I thought it was. Anything down here? Ah, bear coin. Definitely worth coming back for it, even though you guys may not think so. If you guys are an avid Donkey Kong Country player, then you guys know what it's used for. Alright, just bananas, nothing else? Okay. Wait a minute, I believe... Okay, we got the one goodie. You're supposed to land me on the ledge of this cliff, dude. I don't know what the hell that was. There's a lot of little, just, hidden treasures everywhere. Okay. Yeah, give me the secret in the most obvious spot. Like, seriously. How much of a secret, then, is it? I believe this is one of those levels where a lot of the stuff is just cram-packed together, you know? Is there anything over there? I don't think there... No, there's nothing. Oh, come on, goddammit. Got stuck behind the waterfall again. There's another thing. The level goes in and out of the background a lot, so you're gonna have to be careful with that. Ugh. Also, one of my least favorite levels is in Mechano, so that's another reason why I didn't want to do it. It's called Logi Labyrinth. It's not a difficult level, it's just so slow-paced it gets annoying. Like, I don't mind levels where you can just run around, but that's not one of them. Well, you can, but only for a certain amount of time. Can I, like, get that O? I actually do like to collect lives, and... If you screw that up, you have to die. That's just evil. Maybe you could get from it up top, I don't know. Anyways, collect 20 stars. Oh, there's some there. Hopefully I got them all. And we did. Perfect. Oh, another thing is, I believe in the added world called Pacifica, it's either the collect the bananas or collect the stars. I believe it's collect the stars, though. That they, like, made pretty much all the bonuses that. It's like, seriously? You can do any of the other bonuses? Nothing over there. Let me guess, there's a secret back here. Yep, another free bear coin. Go figure. Hey, bees. Ah, hey, Perry the Parakeet. Perry is awesomely awesome. As long as I don't let him die, because he cannot kill bees. He's like the most hated animal buddy in the game, because he's not really much of an animal buddy. He's more of a animal nuisance. Ah, free one up. I technically got two because of the bananas as well, so. Two one-ups! It's a two-up. Free up balloon. Yay! And also the bonus. See, everything's in the second half of the level so far. Don't know why they do that, but they do that. And, wow, collect the stars again, really? Uncreative! Should I have, like, a bonus in the game like this, but where it's like, collect bananas? They actually don't. That's the funny thing. And we got the bonus coin. And I believe each of these two worlds, the bosses actually give you a useful item to get a ship. So you're not going to be getting any bonus coins. Oh, and, yeah, so for this one, I believe the trick is to throw this upwards so it goes slow, and then wait till it gets halfway, and then, you know, just use the barrel to boost over. And another level bites the dust. Oh, hang on, I got a text message. My girlfriend just feels sick at work. She's been getting up really early, and it's been screwing with her. Ah, creeping clasps. Oh my god, one of these levels again. Oh, looks like I need Kitty right away. Why'd you pick that up? I don't know why they picked that up. Also, I believe the background of this level is the wrong color. I believe this level should be tinted red. Believe, and also I think you're not allowed in the water. Yep, our fishy friend is in there. I believe fishy friend also gets a level in this game. Or in this world, in this game, obviously. Like, where he's actually very useful. Slash... annoying. These wharf levels are just random, and this one's really easy. This one's like a joke. It's like, oh, you can't fall down there. You know, it's not easier said than done. It's literally as easy as being said, you know? Does that make sense to you guys? I don't know if it did, but coin get! I do like the music here, though. Like, once you actually get to the music. Oh, hey, there's a one up there for some reason. Yeah, these are clasps. Of all different kinds, but... they're clasps. Boo-doo-boo-ba-doo-doo. I don't know what to talk about while dealing with these guys. Fuck you, Chomper. I actually don't even know his name. This one's easy again if you have Dixie. Luckily, that's who we're using. We already got both bonuses done here. At least they had a clasp freaking bonus. Would have seemed weird, you know, to have, like, a clasp level without clasp in the bonus. Fuck! That was bad. What the hell?! Oh yeah, that was weird. My character went to the side and got me killed, so I just lost an extra life for no reason at all. Maybe Kitty will actually beat a level for once. He hasn't beat a level in forever. Would be kind of cool. Oh, we're out without music for a while. Can't remember if the original game was like that too, but I find it funny how long it takes the music to actually start up. See, like, some of these levels are just cram-packed all into, like, one small area. Filled with lots of enemies, but it's small. You know what? I want Kitty to actually beat the level, plus I want to get up there and see what's up there, so... Kitty? Get that, and throw Dixie up here, please. Oh, bear coin. Definitely worthwhile. Oh, text message again. Hang on. Okay, anyways, let's continue on our adventure and go to the next waterfall level known as Tracker Barrel Trek. Depending on how fast these next two levels go, we can actually get the entire world done. Which is actually not what I intended to do, but at this rate, this is how it's gonna be. Thank God I made my lives back, though. Ah, there was a bear coin there. Nothing that way. Ah, see, now it makes more sense. Screw off, spiny wannabes. You guys remember Spiny from Donkey Kong Country 2? I guess if I ever played that game, you guys do. I don't know, I preferred him as an enemy. Ah, bonus. And we have collect 70 stars. My favorite waterfall level is actually Bobbing Barrel Brawl, and that's, later in the game. I think it'd be in the waterfall world, but no, it's actually in the snowy world, I believe. Yeah, snowy world literally has two snowy levels, and one of them you can walk around in, that's it. Biggest disappointment for me in a snow world, man. Like, I love snow levels. If you guys know me, you guys know that already. What the hell? Oh, come on, game. That was a dick move. Everything's going so well. Fuck you, you're now down here with us. Kind of the bananas are back, but they're literally just stationary. That's funny. Goodbye. Ah, that was the midway barrel right there, too. Come on, that was a dick move. Nope, nothing over there. Okay. Always worth double-checking. Hey, Ellie the Elefante is back. Yo, bitches, it's me, Ellie the Elefante. What's this? I can destroy humongoloid sapsuckers with my... water jizz attack. Can you... Okay, fine. Don't hit the damn bee. All up to you, bro. Bash the bad Dinotrons. You can't suck up water in this bonus. I don't know, just like sing some kind of corny song along to, you know, like the, you know, bonuses and stuff. And there we go! I just gotta get to coin, which I believe is used, or you get using Ellie, and I mean as in we need her, because she's the barrel. Now let me fill up my water. That's what the water bottle said. That was just bad. Ah, fuck that. I knew that was coming too. Why I continued to do it, I will never know. You? Thank you, actually hit the damn thing. It even tells you to press R, which is what I'm doing. Oh, well, why do I have all the collectibles and everything, yet... You know, you give me another DK barrel right there. It's always weird when they do that. It's like, how much more of the level is there? One bee and some lizards? Yep, I knew it all along. Also, how many times have I played this game? Oh, I guess it's for this part. Fuck. Still beat the level, though, nonetheless. Okay. I guess we have time to do the last level. This looks like there'd be, like, a secret right there, you know? And this is Fish Food Frenzy, so we have another underwater level. But this time using our best friend, Coco the Gay Clownfish Eater. And I don't mean gay in a derogatory sense, you know? That was like a thing reoccurring in the past where they called him that. Not to, like, you know, make fun of gays. So don't get all, like, offensive. Don't eat the urchin. Urchins make his tummy sick. But, it was just a joke back in the past when you first played this game, you know? Like, all the old school gamers, all the old, like, YouTubers, Newfiebonga, and, you know, people like that. And let's go in. Don't eat that urchin, man. Collect 15 bananas. Wow! Just in a random pool of water. This is so much fun. So fun indeed. My head is going to burst from joy. Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo! Like, this is really easy. If you want to break from a hard level, this is definitely the way to go. Like, this isn't really a water world. A lot of people call it the water world. I call it the waterfall world. He just ate an urchin while I was coming into the game, so... Fuck you! Don't eat me! You fucking dick! You passed the fucking... Wah-ha-ha, kitty. Wah-ha-ha. That was like a dick move there, fish breath. I just realized this world is a lot shorter than the forest world, at least in length. I don't know if it's because, like, the levels you don't have to redo, or the levels are shorter or something in this world, but... I don't know, it just feels like 19 minutes, well, 20 minutes in now. Can you not eat him? And, you know, we're... almost at the boss. Can you eat the damn fish instead of getting hungry? And, goddammit, I was too busy paying attention to our buddy here that eats everything to not notice that I ran into a clownfish. Can you please eat this one instead of me this time? Thank you. Can you eat these damn fish? Now, remember the second bonus being in a very annoying spot that a lot of people forget about. Oh god, he's starting to turn red. But I believe it's after the halfway point, I think. Can you eat the fish? Dude, eat the... dude! No! You fucking numpty! You're supposed to eat the goddamn motherfucking fish! How hard is it for you to eat a damn fish? Oh my god, guys, he is dumber than a sack of shit. Worst thing is like, these levels are so... this level is so long and drawn out. Like, it's an interesting concept. One that no one likes, but it is an interesting concept, and I'll give them that. At least Donkey Kong doesn't have any auto-scroll. Well, I believe there's technically two auto-scroll levels in all of Donkey Kong Country. That's more like you're on a moving platform. It's not really auto-scroll. That's Castle Crush in level... or in Donkey Kong Country 2. And then, Ripsaw Rage or something like that in this game. Don't you dare eat him! Yes, just continuously eat the urchins and not the fish. Yeah, because you make sense, you goddamn freaking fish. Can you... thank you, you actually ate the fish this time. And we were at the checkpoint! God damn you, fish. What is your name anyway? I want to make fun of you, because you're an asshole to me. I do like how it's kind of like Donkey Kong Country 2... or Donkey Kong Country 1 underwater music, you know? Don't turn red and eat me. Thank you. Oh, come on! I shouldn't have taken damage there, because... can you actually eat these fish, please? Thank you. Nope, he ate it again. God damn it, motherfucker. Yeah, we're gonna die here. We're gonna die. Oh, look, we didn't actually die, and look, there's another fish. I assume he ate the fish since he was off screen for so long. Nope, apparently he didn't. No, I'm not grabbing that anytime soon. Oh, shit. Can you eat the clownfish? Thank you. I don't really get how they're clownfish. They're not orange, but apparently they are. I think I missed the bonus, actually. Maybe. No! Man, if I miss the bonus, it's gonna be annoying. Because I hate getting the bonus here. Wait, no, never mind. Actually, it's back here. I believe it's in this one. Wait, no, it's not. Shit, I know where it is. I know where it is, guys. It's in the third one. But it's up above. I always think it's down, but it's actually above. Where the fuck is that fish? Why is there no fish there? No, you're not eating that urchin, buddy. Oh, look, you actually ate the fish when I wanted you to. There's a bear coin down there, and as much as I want to get it, I can't. Dude! Woo! Woo! Okay. Going fine here. Get way above him. Turn you around that way. Woo! Almost... fuck you. Fuck you and all that you hold dear to you. sponsor. Enjoy some clownfish fondue, I guess. I don't know. Can you eat this one? Oh, God! We did it. Oh, and now we gotta do this again, but as an actual bonus. Yay! Now it's like, please eat the fish, man. Please don't screw this over for me. Eating all the fishes. It's actually just eating fish because it's not multiple species of fish. You can only use fishes if there's more than one type of fish, but they're all clownfish, so it's only fish. And the souls actually spawn in the middle, by the way, game. He's like, I'm sad. And goodbye, fish brain. He didn't get sad, he's just like, I'll stop following you, I guess. At least they give me, you know, our other Kong buddy here. What did you do that for? Yahoo! God, that level always takes so long. Anyways, let's go to the boss, Squirt's Showdown. This is an Ellie boss fight. Come on, game. You're evil. Now you just have to shoot him in the eye a bunch of times. Honestly, don't remember how many times, but... So far, so good. Well, that was a joke, right? Wait, why did he shoot? I don't know why he shot the water. Or she. There we go. Whoa. Whoa. There we go, boss fight done. That's how easy it is, guys.
What on earth was that, Collins? I don't think I really want to know. Still, it's another step closer to rescuing Diddy.
Yeah, not Donkey Kong, but whatever. Anyways, guys, if you enjoyed today's episode, remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time for some more Donkey Kong Country 3. Peace out.